Hello, this is Kevin with Bangard Inc., and today we're going to be taking a look at the Sage Estimating version 24 release that just came out. There's a couple things that caught my attention that are going to be pretty handy for clients, so that's sort of the topics I'm going to look at. So you might want to go back through the release notes. There's a few other things that was added, but I'm just going to kind of focus on the main ones that caught my eye. One of them was the ability to flag recommended fields in your cover page. Let's open up an estimate and see what that looks like. When people enter cover page information, none of these fields have really ever been required or recommended or forced you or anything of that nature. So especially now that, you know, like project type, that now has a standardized drop-down list that was added in the last version prior to this one. You can now, you know, create your own custom fields for a lot of the different fields so they can have their own drop-down list or what type of the fields they are. So now it actually becomes more important to say, you know, these are the fields that as a company, we really recommend that you fill out. To set that up, we actually go through Management Console to do it. So I'm going to go ahead and minimize this estimate. I'm going to bring my Management Console up. I'm going to go to my estimates. And I don't want to click on edit or anything of that nature at this point. I just want to highlight any single estimate, doesn't matter which one. And when I click on this little asterisk here, this is how you set what you want the recommended fields to be. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it. And this pulls up all the different fields. So maybe I want to make sure that, you know, project type is pretty critical. Maybe I want to make sure the estimators are putting in their estimator name. And now keep in mind with the prior version or another YouTube video out there that I've done previously, there's a recording on, you know, how to go through and set up your estimators as a drop-down list to get consistency there and so forth. Maybe it's in critical that we put in, you know, what's a plan date or revision that the plans that we're working with at this point. So I could just kind of go through all the different fields and actually pick what fields I want to basically recommend that the estimator fill out. And I'm going to go ahead and hit OK to accept it. And you'll notice here that those fields actually popped red. So those are the ones that are recommended. And we'll see that when we actually go into like create an estimate and so forth, where those actually show up on the estimate information also. The other thing that's kind of on that same similar grounds is these sections, general, job classifications, you know, things of that nature. Maybe there's a particular order of, well, we don't do any much with user-defined fields, but we do the address. And maybe I want the address above the, you know, job classifications or whatever order you might want them in. So this icon over here stands for reorder settings. And that will actually allow you to change the order that those fields are in. So maybe we get awarded jobs quite frequently. So maybe the job cost information is critical. So you can actually move that up. So now it's going to be the general information and then my job cost information secondary. So that way you can kind of see it's already taken shape a little bit about there's my general, there's my job cost information, there's my job classification. So that way you can kind of really go in and organize, you know, what are these things that people need to fill in and which ones are maybe not as critical and things like that. So it just comes in real handy to kind of go through and, you know, for those that are using crews and things like that, maybe I don't want to go down through the list to, you know, find my crew section. I want to move that more towards the top and those type of things. So it's just real handy that you can actually highlight your different groupings using the little up down arrow keys. You can kind of, you know, move them around to reorganize that content in the order that you want them. With that being said, you could do something similar with the database side of things also. So if I take a look at my database, the database kind of has similar groupings also. So this is where I could set up my different list of project types and estimators and, you know, any custom fields that I'm going to set up and you know, those type of things. So you can now also reorganize this list. So same looking icon, not as many groups for the database as there is an estimate, but that way you can sit there and say, well, I want the, you know, job cost information to be more towards the top or something of that nature. And there again, you can kind of move them around to whatever order that you want to see that information as you go through. So just kind of handy to, there again, kind of make it more, what do we as a company, you know, want to fill in, need to fill in, things of that nature. So that way you can kind of set the order of that. So now if I go ahead and come back to estimating, if I were to go back and look at a particular estimate, then under my estimate info, I'm going to see a few things take shape. I'm going to see the order of them is going to be changed, and I'm going to have some that are in red for my recommended entering. As I take a look there, I could see there's my, you know, job classification. In my case, I had filled out a project type. I filled out an estimator. So right now, this is the only field that, you know, I forgot to not put in the very first time through and so forth. But this is where if these were blank, they would actually pop up red also, just to kind of let you know that you've got something, you know, outstanding. Down here in the bottom, there's a little legend. So the asterisk is just kind of indicating that there's, you know, what fields are the ones that are recommended. And then it also, the double asterisk just kind of lets you know that you've still got something outstanding. So if I come back and I tell it a project type here, let's say that this is plans dated 1-1 of 24. And now as I look at this, you know, I'm not going to see my double asterisks over here for in red anymore, because at this point, everything's filled out. I don't see my double asterisks next to my job classification. So, you know, those basically just are key points to kind of pop where my recommended fields are. Now, with that being said, it is just that. It is recommended. So I could still hit OK and accept it without, it's not required. It's not forcing me to necessarily do it. It's just primarily as a company, here's the fields that we want filled in to try to help, you know, remind people what those key fields are and give them some sort of a, you know, red prompts to kind of help facilitate getting them entered. So marking recommended fields in your estimate page, reordering those different sections and so forth. The last one I want to take a look at has to do with alternates and statuses. When we go to advanced and we go to statuses, in prior versions, we always had to go through and set these up for each estimate. So some people, you know, if I've got included and excluded, well, some people only use two, so it wasn't all that big of a deal just to, you know, set up a couple. Some people got a fairly elaborate list of different choices about, you know, is it approved, contract signed, is it approved verbal, is it something that's rejected, and, you know, things of that nature. So you can really get some different statuses set up. But as there again, as a company, it's nice to keep some sort of consistency between them. So in this version here, whatever database you're currently in, so I'm in my how-to database at the moment, is the database that these are going to be added to. So if you're a company that has multiple databases, you might need to go through and add them to, you know, whatever the applicable databases are that you need them in. In this case, I just went off to my statuses like I normally do. Instead of hitting add, I'm going to go to database. So this look is kind of like the same look that you have like when you do WBS codes and things like that from within an estimate. So I'm going to look at my database. In this case here, it's going to basically pull up an empty box, because in this case, I don't have any built yet. So this is my database alternate status. When I hit edit, it'll basically light up where I can actually, you know, do a search and look for existing ones. Or in this case, I'm going to hit add. So I'm going to go ahead and say that I need one for included. Then I'm going to say is include. I'm going to say excluded. And that one is not going to be included. Maybe I'm going to have another one for rejected, and whatever the status may be. So there I've created just a handful of different ones. When I hit OK, those will now be in my database. They're not necessarily in any estimates yet. They're just in the database. If I go ahead and I just cancel this down and close it down, you'll notice that my estimate is still blank. So when you go to create new estimates, you would go to database so you could see all the values in your database. And basically, you could use your control key to basically highlight whichever ones you want in this estimate. So in this case, I'm going to do them all. Or I could click once on the first and hold down my shift key and, you know, do a whole block at once. And when I hit select, now it just dropped all those in this estimate. So now I've got all those statuses available for me in this particular estimate without having to set them up each time. So those were some of the big highlights I thought in version 24. There were, like I said, a few other ones, so make sure to check out the release notes, but some pretty handy stuff. So let me know what you think, and thanks for watching.